Hey guys, so my internet died 3 days ago and I've been lying in fetal position sucking my thumb since. So I thought I'd do something productive and make another TK tutorial. Again, my Toribash has problems downloading customs even when I do have internet, so all these lucky people will remain anonymous. Although for some reason it still has joint colours and hair for a couple of them, so I don't really know what's up. A bit random, but hey. So we'll start with this replay. Welcome to Snapkick Defense 101. Defending snap kicks is one of the main reasons I start off by putting my hand towards the middle. Here I would normally hold my left shoulder and just lean my body forwards at the hips to grab the leg without too much risk of my wrist breaking. But if I did that, his right hand looks like it's likely to grab my defending hand. So I can either just grab his right hand with my left to move my body out of the line of the kick while using my right hand to defend other attacks or to help set up my own ones. Or I can bring my left hand down to his knee joint hard and fast, avoiding the grab and breaking his knee. This is risky since if he faked the snap kick and I miss with my hand, I go way off balance, but I'm pretty sure he's going to kick out, so I risk it and it pays off. And now it's hard for him to defend anything, so I bring up my leg quickly to put my foot up his arse, which isn't very pleasant despite what your dad says. Going back here a second. The power in this kick comes from both the upwards and forwards motion of my leg. Notice my foot is kicking upwards while extending my hips is pushing the whole leg forward, and at the same time I'm pulling his body down and into my body with my left shoulder, elbow and pec. Kicks like these often make contact a lot quicker and can be more powerful than those standard kicks where you would contract your hip and extend your elbow and pec. Play around with it until you get it right, because it can require a little trial and error, but it's really good. Then the next kick is kinda unnecessary, but no point spacing it. You might as well try and attack again. It's just good practice, and it's unsportsmanly to not make any effort to engage with your opponent again. So, on to the next one. This one is a bit more complicated. Again, I put my hand towards the middle, keeping myself relaxed, and again it looks like he's going to go for a snap kick, so I keep my hand out there and bring up my right leg ready for an attack. But he was faking the snap kick to set up a left kick instead. Not a problem, since I left my hand out there hovering rather than bringing it down hard to catch it. I think he's still going to try and kick out with his right leg, which won't hit me if I can grab that thigh or knee, so he'll effectively waste his next turn. So I'm going to use this extra time to try and spin round for a harder left kick. But he didn't kick out, and his right punch is now lined up perfectly with my head. Or he could switch his chest and pecs and hit me with the left punch instead, so I need to abandon the kick and defend that. In TK, about 80% of the time, the winner is the one who lands the first big hit, so defending and attacking are equally important. And as you can see, ungrabbing here will stifle his attempt, change his momentum and leverage completely. So I bring round my right hand to defend a possible left punch, or still that left kick, and I raise my left arm to block the potential right punch. So he still decided to go for the kick, so I'm gonna grab that leg with my right hand. Very important that I keep the wrist relaxed to stop it from breaking. And I push off the ground with my right leg and start rotating my chest and pecs right to set up the right kick. Notice here again that I'm not contracting my hip, as the kick lands more cleanly if I hold my hip. And I'm lowering my shoulder, bending lumbar weight, contracting abs and extending my glutes to power up the kick more. I'm also contracting my right pec as the kick looks likely to miss if I extend it. And as you can see, I break his ass in two places, well done again. I'm not in a good position to be able to grab him again, so all that's left to do is leave him to DQ. So that's it for now. Thought I'd keep this one short and sweet. Thanks for all the positive comments on my last tutorial. If you still want more, I'm happy to make them. I'm also going to work with other Evo members to make an ABD tutorial video, since it's probably the most popular mod at the moment. See you later, everyone.